Sign up to the SBR network and use your free daily bet points to earn real-world prizes. Click on the page and start winning now.
Hi, and welcome to SBRForum.com. My name is Ross Benjamin. I will be previewing the NCAA Tournament's second-round game in the Midwest Regional between the number 11 seed Tennessee Volunteers and the number 6 seed University of Massachusetts Minutemen. The game will take place at the PNC Arena in Raleigh, North Carolina on Friday with the opening tip scheduled for 2:45 p.m. Eastern Time. Currently, as we speak, the Tennessee Volunteers are a 4-point favorite, and the posted total in this game is 135. Tennessee received an at-large bid out of the SEC as they finished third during the regular season in the SEC standings. They advanced to the SEC tournament semifinals before losing to the number one team in the country, Florida, 56-49. Massachusetts finished tied for fifth in the Atlantic 10. And this is a Massachusetts team that was eliminated in the Atlantic 10 tournament quarterfinals by George Washington. Well, Tennessee comes off a thrilling win as they participated in the play-in game of the NCAA tournament on Wednesday evening in Dayton, Ohio. Tennessee took on the Iowa Hawkeyes and were installed as a 2-point favorite in the game, and they came away with a 78-65 overtime win. The game was deadlocked at 64 at the end of regulation time, and then Tennessee just dominated Iowa in the overtime session, outscoring them 14-1. This is an excellent defensive squad from Tennessee. They allow just 61 points per game, which is good for 17th in the country, and they're one of the best rebounding teams in the nation at plus 8.9 rebounding per game differential. That's third best in the country, folks. They're monsters on the boards. In addition to their stellar defense, their last six games, they've allowed their opponents just 50 points per contest. Now, the UMass Minutemen, a lot of people were surprised at the fact they received a number 6 seed in the respect that they were projected as anywhere from an 8 to an 11 seed. Also, this is a UMass team that went just 7-6 down the stretch in their own conference. However, when you look at their schedule and you examine it more closely, you could see what the NCAA Tournament Committee was looking at. They won over 6 teams this season that qualified for the NCAA Tournament, including 3 from the non-conference predator schedule. They defeated BYU, they defeated VCU, and they also defeated New Mexico. In addition, a couple of NIT teams this season were losers to UMass as well, as the Minutemen knocked off both LSU and Clemson. This is a Massachusetts team that will be playing with 8 days of rest. They haven't played since last Thursday. The one thing that I'm looking at with Tennessee here is they're at a distinct disadvantage. They played the late game on Wednesday evening. It didn't end till around midnight Eastern time. And now they have to play a team that's this well rested in UMass in approximately 38 hours later. A very tough task. However, when I'm looking at a selection in this game, my personal experience is when you have a disparity in seeds such as this, you have a number 11 seed in Tennessee playing a number 6 seed in Massachusetts, and it's an early round game such as this, and Tennessee is the lower seed, is a 4-point favorite. The books aren't wrong very often, and more times than not, the lower seed that's a favorite comes out on top. For that reason alone, I'm going to have a very small lean on the Tennessee Volunteers, -4 over UMass in this situation. My name is Ross Benjamin. You've been watching the NCAA Tournament Preview on SBRForum.com. Be sure to join me in the next couple days as I also will be analyzing, highlighting, and giving you free projections on the 4 games in the quarterfinals of the Midwest region. Thank you for watching and have a fantastic day.